Welcome to the SA lawn. Welcome to my scalped and spike-rolled Kentucky bluegrass lawn, people, and welcome to another video. If you were looking for a scalping video or a spiking video, you've joined the wrong one. This is a top dress video, Owens, and we are in the middle of October, maybe edging towards the end of October. It's probably the 18th or 19th of October, somewhere there. I'm not keeping track of the date, but it's a beautiful flipping October's afternoon. And why is that? Because it's not a blazer, a scorcher, and I'm not burning myself to bits. The whole day was a little bit cloudy, and I reckon it's a great day for top dressing my lawn. Now, I'm not going to go into too much in-depth detail. There was a renovation video a couple of days ago on the Kikuyu. Just go and watch that if you want a lot of information. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy this video. Welcome. Okay, and so here is my top dress medium. It's a 50-50 mixture. It's got red topsoil and 50% organic matter in it. And Jacob there is doing wonders. Say hello, Jacob. Say hello. Hello, that's Jacob working for me at the bed shop. He's also helping here with distributing this and also screening it. We built a lacquer screening thing there just now to take out most of the big compost clumps and also, you know, stones and those type of things. So it's a little bit finer because this lawn doesn't grow as aggressive as the Kikuyu. But I'm top dressing with organic matter. Like I said in the previous video, the soil qualities in this area of this lawn, the top part, is horrendous. Is absolutely shocking. Doesn't hold on to water, doesn't hold on to nutrients. It feels an absolute fear of flip for nutrients and water. It dries out almost instantaneously and it just looks not so lacquer and it just doesn't perform. So for the next couple of years, we're going to focus on organic matter, amending the soil, doing the right thing, doing the correct thing. Okay, let's do it. All right, Owens, so a couple of low areas have been spotted, have been noted, and those I will target. And I must be honest with you, last year I top dressed with sand and I absolutely loved it. Also here, it's a couple of low areas. Now, unfortunately, I have to work with soil, which is not the best medium or the most enjoyable medium to work with initially. And I think the low areas here, guys, are, look at that, it looks like almost like a circle type thing. And I've learned now that many years back there used to grow some trees in this area, and I'm pretty sure these are dead and decaying tree roots that is sinking a little bit down, you know, that organic matter breaking up of those dead roots and now creating a bit of a low area. Nothing serious to worry about. This lawn really doesn't have a lot of indentations and unevenness, so I'm talking really like little dips, like probably 10-15 mils, which this medium should sort out with this application. All right, guys, so this time I'm gonna make it a lot more effortless for myself. I've got just over a cubic meter of this medium, which should be more than enough for my 170 square meters here, especially cut this low. I don't really want to smother this grass type. It doesn't cope a lot very well with smothering. So I'm just gonna take my Kikuyu Guru Lawn Leveler and start dragging the crap out of this, the easy way. Make a few piles here and just drag the thing. Guys, all jokes aside, this is probably the best invention, besides cylinder mowers, that has ever been created. I've probably top dressed 40 square meters here in about 2 minutes, absolutely effortless. I'm huffing and puffing a bit, but I'm extremely unfit. Best invention ever. Well done, Kikuyu Guru. All right, so still quite rocky and pebbly, but luckily all small ones. And the nice thing about scalping some shorties, you can really work them to the side off the edge because they don't really get worked in in between the leaf blades. So the more you do this, the more the sand in this medium works its way through the leaf blade onto the actual soil layer and works its way in between the thatch and all the ugly areas where you really want it. And especially into the poked holes, guys. The more you work it, the more medium finds its way through the poked holes into the root zone and feeds it there, and have it properly drained, have the water properly drained through into the root zone. Okay, so I've turned on the lights and just look how flippin' awesome this top section looks, Owens. Check at that. Look how flat this thing comes out. All right, Owen, so a little bit difficult to see under the lights, but awesome, awesome results. Really, most of this medium worked its way this very, very short leaf blade, through the very, very short leaf blade, onto the actual soil layer. So I think we're gonna have pretty quick recovery, especially if we are seeing temperatures that is about 10 degrees lower. I'm talking about 23, 24 degrees. I must say, it turned into quite hard work. After it was easy work, turned into quite hard work to get all these stones, tons of it, guys. Look here, a whole heap of stones. Not very big, but still not something I want on my lawn. And especially I feel if I remove that, I'll have faster recovery. Also, yeah, huge piles of stones and probably a little bit of medium that I'm gonna waste. I'll probably work this into my garden beds. Here's quite a bit, actually. But I think that's enough medium for now. Honestly, November, December, we're getting a lot of people over. Don't want to sit with a sandlogged lawn here, guys. I'd rather do it more often and have recovery within a week or two. So I'll keep you updated as to how this lawn recovers. Obviously, it was burnt by this horrific weather. But let's see how it recovers. Obviously, now, next 8 days or so, we should have lower temperatures and we should see a Kentucky bluegrass lawn that recovers a little bit better, or recovers at least from the drought stress, from the heat stress. Don't worry, this is just the aluminium rubbing off on my hands. So guys, I'll call that a huge success. The Kentucky bluegrass renovation, done and dusted. You can tick that one. If you enjoyed it, be sure to subscribe to the channel and be sure to like this video. Really helps it with the algorithm, and especially if you don't mind to leave a comment at the bottom. Talking about comments, shoot any questions in the comment section below. If I run into them, I'll answer them. If I don't get back to you, go to Instagram, the South African Lawn on Instagram. Shoot me a DM there, pretty active there, and I'll almost reply all messages there. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Cheers for now. Bye-bye. So I'll be honest, my wife told me that my entire forehead is black of that aluminium, and I didn't notice it. How lovely. So I'm busy removing all these stones and wood chips and whatever, and I thought, let me just quickly give you a daytime update. I know it's a little bit hard to see the things under the light. So guys, some areas went a little bit heavier, and all of these poke holes are so beautifully filled. Just have a look there. I think it looks awesome, guys. I've really worked it through the grass leaf blades. Kentucky bluegrass, I never want to smother. If you don't see any leaf blade with cool season grasses, there's a good chance that some of that will die off and not all of it will come through. And it's not growing as aggressive. You'll probably sit with an area that takes a little bit longer to recover. So I've got a little bit heavier areas, like right here. But still, you can see in the heaviest areas, I'm making sure that I can see even the tiniest bits of grass leaf blades sticking through. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I think it looks awesome. Let me show you and stop talking for a bit. And I'll see you in the next video.